The next editor in C Design is the log editor. With this editor, we can configure the built-in data logger. There are two types of logs: periodic, where the variable or the variables are logged every a given sample time. The second is event, where the variable or the variables are recorded, logged according to a given trigger condition. The maximum size of the logs is 4 megabytes. Now we can create a couple of logs, one of each type. I have already opened CDesign. We have to select, as usual, the configuration we want to edit. Start the logs. Let's create a new log. The first will be periodic. In this exercise, we will log the inlet temperature. So I will call it log of temperature. Double click somewhere here to configure it. We can start with the sample time. So the variable will be logged every this time. In a real application, this time is about 5-10 minutes. But in this exercise, just to have some samples in a short time, we can set 5 seconds. Then total time, 1 week, that is 7 days. The files are circular, that is, when the data logger reached 7 days of records, it starts to override the oldest one, the oldest values. In the next tab, we can select the variables we want to log. So there are no variables. Why? As usual, only the variables that have the corresponding flag here are visible in the corresponding editor. So to see variables in the log editor, we have to set this flag. So we can select some variables. In this case, we need just the temperature, but I select some other variables just to have some more variables in the editor. And also the compressors, because later we need also the compressors. Log, and also here. Okay, all. Remember to save in order to see the variables. So here are. So for the periodic log, we want to log only this one. We can select more than one. So if more than one, the system will log all these variables, okay, of course. Okay, temperature. Next log, that is event type. In this case, probably the only log that makes sense in this application is the log of the status of the devices. So we can log the status of the compressors. So every time a compressor start or stop, we can log its status. So I will call it log of compressors. Event type, that's correct. How many records? In the previous case, the number of records depend on the total time and the sample time, and the system automatically indicates total number of records. In case of event, we have to specify it manually. So these 10,000 records take about 60 kilobytes. So these two logs occupy 1.2 megabyte out of the 4 that are available. Okay, we have to configure this editor, this log, double click. There are two tabs here. In the first, we can configure the trigger or the triggers. Probably the name of the tab is not the best. Anyway, here we have to select configure the triggers. So when the variables that will be indicated here, selected here, will be recorded. So we want to record the compressor status. So the triggers are the 4 variables representing the compressors. So when one of these variable change, there are two options, change or alarm. Alarm is very particular, and I leave you read the manual to understand how it works. Typically, we use the change event. You can see that for the Boolean variables, there are no other options. In this column, while for the real integer data type, there is also the minimum delta. That is, for example, in this case, only when the temperature change by minimum 1 degree, for example, or half degree, the trigger is fired and the system will record the variables. Okay, so for Boolean it's not necessary. There are other two options, that is only when the trigger start or stop, and other properties, but also in this case you can read the manual. So when one of these variables change, the system will log these variables. In this exercise will be the same. So the compressor status are the triggers and also the variables that are recorded. Well, okay, now the logs takes about 100 kilobytes, a bit more because we have selected the variables. Now we are ready to test it in the controller. As usual, we have to build everything, build this strategy. Okay, CMask not necessary because I didn't change it. Upload. Okay, I am connected via internet. Upload. While it uploads, I can start PGD web. Okay, so unit is on, compressors are off, so increase one compressor, two compressor, 3, 4. So now the event logger should have recorded at least eight records, all compressor off, and then the first on, second on, third on, fourth on, and then the same off. The periodic logger has recorded this half a minute of time, that is 6 to 10 logs. That's enough. Now we can see what the data logger has recorded. So how to export the logs? Here is there are two options as usual. The first is using a system mask, system menu, logger. The second is using a specific function block. I will use the first option. First, export logs by system mask. So enter in the system menu, alarm enter for 2 seconds, logger, we can export and other options. Now we can export, here are the two logs that we have configured. We can also export all and export log operation. Okay, press enter. The point is, where are the files? As usual, it is written the export logs exports in the public flash memory or the pen drive if plugged. In this moment, there isn't the pen drive plugged in the controller, so it has exported in the internal public flash. So now I'm connecting the controller to the Pico via USB cable, So this is the internal memory, and here are the two files that it has exported. They are in standard CSV format, that is a text file. We can open via in Excel, but also with the notepad. So here are the logs. This is today. The timestamp is in a standard format. I don't remember what is the exact standard. The timestamp and the value of the variable. There is also here is boot. This is an event. So this is the evidence that the controller has started, the data logger is started. There are other two events. Here in the periodic logs, there are two options: event variables, stop event, and restart event. Here we can specify two boolean variables that can stop or restart the logger. I told you that the logger manages circular files. So once reached 7 days, it starts to override the oldest value. So if we don't want to override the old values, for example, when occurs a very critical condition, we can stop the event, stop the data logger in order to prevent the override of the values. So with this we can stop, with the other we can restart. And these two events, stop and restart, are logged here in the records. It is possible to restart the logger also from the system menu. Here is restart logs. We can see also the other log, the log of the compressor. So time event for compressors, and here are the four values. All off, only one on, two on, three on, four on. Okay, here are not sorted. Okay, but it doesn't matter. Well, that's all. So there are two types of logs, periodic and event, maximum 4 MB. It is possible to export using system menu or function block. And regarding function block, this is a very powerful option because since there is a limited space for the logs, the export logs allows, for example, to export the logs, for example, the logs of the last day, every midnight. It is possible to export in internal memory that is 90 MB, and in the last controller it is possible also to extend it. So if the strategy export the logs of the last day every midnight, it is possible to have the history of the temperature, for example, for the whole life of the controller. Well, that's all also for the logs. Thank you for watching.